Could you put that in the chat box? Which city are you joining from? Are your messages going directly to Taiba? Are you not, are they not going to everybody in the group? Ah, that's the problem. Okay. Shruti's from Delhi. All right, no problem. Okay. What challenges you all are facing? What challenges you all are facing basically with the high ticket sales? Are you facing the problem with fear of rejection? Are you facing the problem with objection handling? Are you facing the problem with justifying the offer prices? What exactly are you doing? Let me see. You haven't tried it yet, so you are missing with the entire flow of how it needs to be taken, right? Yes. Who else? Who else has tried something? Krishma, Ibrahim, what are your current challenges? Right. Shruti, what are you into? What are you selling?
I am into relationship coaching.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah,
Yes.
so
And
it's
you
mainly
offer.
one to one, and I really want to go organic. I have no plans of starting with the ads or something. So yeah,
All right,
I
lovely.
haven't tried the high ticket yet.
Great. So if you haven't tried it, Taiba is the best person to tell you how to start with it.
Yeah, that's why
Right.
I'm
Lovely, Shruti. Lovely,
here.
lovely, everybody. Okay, great. Praveen has a problem with pricing and objection. All right. So whatever challenges you all have mentioned here, right? More than this, Taiba will be covering a lot of challenges today inside this workshop. Yes, she'll tell you what all objections come in place, what all processes there, right? She's going to clarify a lots and lots of things for you all. Yes. Plus, she's going to focus on the sales psychology part, right? So more than tactics and strategies, she's going to tell you how to hit somebody's psychology. Yes.
Yeah.
And basically how to make that conversion subconsciously, instead of just trying to be pushy and salesy. Yes. Taiba has basically worked from last 4 years as a coach, and she has impacted the lives of 15,000 plus people in public speaking, in branding, in marketing, and sales. From last 2 years, she's been specializing in high ticket coaching sales, and she has transformed a lot of coaches' lives.
Wow.
Yes. Okay, with that being said, I think it's time to welcome Taiba on the stage. Taiba, can you take it over? People are waiting.
Thank you so much, Simran. Can we give a big round of applause to Simran? She did a great job of starting this session with high energy. Can we also show some appreciation for Simran?
Absolutely.
Awesome. Thank you, Simran. That was done very, very well. So, hi everyone. I like to start my sessions with a high five. So, how many of you would have liked to give me a high five? I was in front of you. Give me a virtual high five.
Yeah.
Shruti is giving. Awesome. So I see a lot of shy people here. Well, to all the shy people, please open up your cameras because you know what? I really want to connect on a one-on-one level with each one of you. This is going to be a very intimate session because this is not going to be a very big session. I thought we'll do a session in which we have limited number of people so that we give attention to each and every individual. So now, without further ado, let's start the session. So, how many of you are comfortable doing high ticket sales? And if you are comfortable, say, I am comfortable. And if you are not, please be honest. It's okay if you're not. It's a skill that you can all learn. So, how
I
many?
am not.
Okay, awesome. So, you're not. And everybody else, you are all big closers, big time closers sitting here in this room. What about you? Come on. See, the more you interact, the more you understand. And the more you understand, the more results you get. Right? So please make sure you are interacting, you are opening up your cameras because your energy is directly proportional to my energy. So the more energy you guys give, the more energy I will give. Awesome. So I haven't heard from a lot of you. What about Ibrahim? How comfortable you are with sales? Grishma said she's not very comfortable. Meena said sometimes yes and sometimes no. Okay, so it's a 50-50. So the room is pretty divided. We have 50% people who say, yeah, we are a little bit comfortable. And if, okay. So I can say 70-80% people, they haven't started their sales journey, right? And they want to get started with it. That is why you are here in this room wanting to, learn more about sales. So, okay. So as Simran mentioned, right? I'm currently a high ticket sales coach. My name is Taiba Mehmood. I am from Bangalore and I heartily welcome each one of you to this masterclass on the psychology of high ticket sales. Now, a lot of you might be thinking, why psychology? Because, even if you make a few sales, but if your mindset is not set, if you don't know what does it really take to understand your customer, to keep going in this game. So maybe you close a few sales, but because the mindset is not set, the mindset become unset. As a result, what will happen is you will go back to square one and you will not be closing a lot of sales. So that is why psychology. So I welcome each one of you. So what are some ground rules for this session? Very, very few ground rules. Number one, please open up your cameras, right? If you can open up your camera, please open up your cameras because that makes me feel that I'm talking to a human being. I'm not talking to a robot, I'm not talking to a blank screen, right? There's a human being, and when I look at you, I understand whether you're getting things, whether you have a question, whether you have a doubt. Your body language tells me, and that helps me to understand if you're getting things or not. Okay, so that's one rule. The second thing that I want you all is keep asking questions, right? There is nothing called as silly question. If you have a question, that's a question, right? There's no intelligent and unintelligent or silly questions. Every question needs to be answered. So instead of just keeping it in your head, that question, doing a lot of buzz in your head, it's better you ask it. Probably somebody else might be helped because of your question, right? And please have a lot of fun. Please keep taking notes, keep enjoying, keep interacting. The chat is open. Keep typing your things in the chat so that I can know what you are thinking, what you're up to, right? So what we'll do is from now on, I'll keep looking at the chat, right? And if required, at times I will ask you to unmute, but we'll have the chat because when we have a chat, it's easier for me to connect with everybody. Like there are eight people in the room, so I can connect with everybody. Everyone clear with the rules? Are we all good? Awesome, awesome, awesome. So, how many of you want to be a pro at understanding the psychology of high ticket sales and you want to start selling high ticket products? Okay, good. Shruti, Ibrahim, what about others? Meena, awesome, awesome. Grishma, awesome, awesome, awesome. Love. Loving the energy now. People are now opening up, showing up. Okay. So we'll learn about all about the psychology part because I truly believe when you understand the psychology of a human being, it is much easier to sell your offer, to tailor your offer, to, really connect, build that rapport, and then sell your product or service. Because if you can't understand the person, what he's going through, it would be really hard to connect. Right? So I'm going to talk a lot about psychology, but before that, can I share a little bit about myself? Because some of you are meeting me for the first time, some of you are not, but still I want to. Can I share? Okay, awesome. So my journey started in 2020 with public speaking. So I started as a public speaking coach, and I was charging 5,000 rupees for my year-long coaching for public speaking. So initially, because I had never earned this kind of money, right? I had never done anything of my own, right? When I got those 5,000 rupees, I was very, very happy. When you get that first money in your bank account, how exciting is this? Grishma, Shruti, Ibrahim, you can all relate, right? How exciting it is. It gave me that dopamine rush. I was feeling happy, excited. But as the months passed by and started taking a track of my accounts, I realized I was investing on a learning management system. I was investing on email marketing tools. I had all these systems. And I was paying around 25, 30,000 for all these systems. And how much money was I making? just 10 or 20,000 a month. So I was putting all my efforts, all my hard work, teaching people, coaching people, and I was in losses. Now that was a little shocking to me because I was doing the work, I was teaching people, I was doing everything right. But why wasn't I earning money? Something was wrong in the business, right? Something was missing. And that led me to think that there are other coaches in this world who are coaching and making money, right? Would you all agree? There are coaches who are teaching and also making money. But I, on the flip side, I was coaching, investing my own money and still not making any money, right? A lot of you might relate because that's how everybody's journey starts, right? So then I started looking for answers because I was stuck somewhere, right? I started looking, where can I go? And I started looking for business coaches who specialized into sales, into marketing, into all these business coaching. And one of the coaches I met was a high-ticket sales coach. And when I shared that this is what I'm doing and this is how much I'm investing, he said, "You are undercharging." And those words still, are with me because I was actually, imagine you are charging 5,000 rupees. In Bangalore, if you go to a school, they charge 2 lakh rupees for an admission for a KG student. And my fees, only 5,000 rupees from professionals for teaching public speaking. So I was clearly charging peanuts. He said, there are coaches who even sell these low ticket offers like 5,000, 10,000. There's nothing wrong in it. But you need to have a high ticket offer. The problem is when you have only one offer, which is a 5,000 or a 10,000 rupee product, and you don't have a product which is 50,000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, something like that. Because how will you sustain the business? How will you pay the team? How will you grow? How will you reach to more clients? So, because you're not charging high ticket, your income and impact both are limited. You're not growing your income, you are not growing your impact. And that hit me that I really need to understand what is this high ticket sales. And then I finally met a coach, right, who taught me number one, the psychology, because I said, if you understand your customer, if you understand your own psychology, and then you start understanding your customer, things become very, very, very easy. Have you had those conversations with a friend where he's trying or she's trying to say something and you can already predict because you know that friend so well? Has that happened with any one of you? And that's what happens in sales. After a point, when you understand the psychology of the customers, you understand what's the objection he's going to give. Is it the objection of time? Is it the objection of money? Is it the objection of commitment? It becomes so obvious because these are all patterns. And when you understand the psychology, you understand every client is different. And once you understand the psychology, everything becomes super easy. All right. So when I first closed that 50,000 rupees deal, my confidence was like skyrocketed. Trust me, I was like, I'm on a different planet. I was so happy. Nina says, wow. Yes, it was a big wow moment for me because I had never sold anything beyond 5, 10, 15,000 rupees. And that 50,000 rupee product was something which changed me. And then I'll tell you something. When I charged more, I paid more attention. I gave more personalization. I gave more support. And even the client was more committed. When people paid 5,000 rupees, they were like, okay, we'll come to the class, we'll think about it, we'll do this. But this client, she was so committed. She took every single class. She took the actions required. She got the results. And I was fascinated. Now she's currently herself a business coach. All right. So how did this happen? Because when people pay more, they pay more attention. When they pay more attention, they understand more. And when you understand things more, can we all agree we all get more results because our actions, our things, we have more clarity. Right? I'll tell you one simple example. Recently, I went to this shop, right, in the mall, which was selling these night suits, right? And usually I don't buy very premium night suits, right? But that day, I don't know, something happened. I went inside the shop, I touched the cloth, it was beautiful. The texture was beautiful, the touch was beautiful, everything was beautiful. And I bought it. Other times when I used to wear my night suit, when I brush in the morning, that toothpaste would fall off, it would make spots. And my night suits would get so dirty. After a while, I would feel like I need to throw them away. But that night suit, that premium night suit I got, there are no spots, I tell you. It is never getting so dirty. I hand wash it because that's the instruction given to me. It's so soft, you can't machine wash it. You have to wash it with your hands. What I'm trying to say is, when you pay a premium price, you pay more attention, your customer pays more attention. You both are more dedicated. And can I tell you get better results. And because you get more and more good results, what happens? You get more referrals. You build more credibility. Your business grows, right? And that is why high ticket is so important. All right. So now I'll be sharing my screen, right? And sharing all the things which are there, which I have prepared for the class. So who all are excited to know the seven principles that I've created for high ticket psychology? Type me. Type me. Come on, everyone. The more you pay attention, the more you learn, the more you earn. Right? Me. Only Shruti wants to learn. Everybody else, Praveen says me. Come on, guys. This is the more you interact, there was a research done and it was shown that when we are in this online environment and we are typing all these things, we are remembering more things because of these cues, right? So keep interacting. Okay, awesome. So can everybody see my screen? Everyone see my screen? Can you all see my screen? Awesome. So the psychology of high ticket sales. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll understand why psychology, why high ticket, all of this. I have already given you a brief, right? And then I'll give you the seven principles, right? And then we'll have a Q&A, and there is a gift for everybody who stays till the end, which is my high converting sales script. So today I'm going to share this sales script, which has really been a game changer for me. It has helped me given many high ticket clients. I've got many high ticket clients out of this. So I'll share this. So please stay till the end. Okay. So why should you learn about high ticket sales? What is the reason for why should you learn? Please type in the chat. What do you feel you should learn high ticket sales? Why should one learn high ticket sales? Why not just skip it? What will happen if you learn? More profit with same effort. Very smart answer, Shruti. More profit with the same kind of effort. That is a very smart answer. What else? To work less and get more. Absolutely. When I was charging 50,000, 1.5 lakh, 2 lakh for my coaching services, even if I get one or two clients, it's good for me. Like it was working for me, right? Because that's the basic you require every single month. If you're living in a metro city, that's the basic amount you require to survive, right? Anybody else? Why do you need a high ticket product if you have not already thought about high ticket product? Why? Why? Come on, guys, only two active people. See, as I said, silly questions are welcome, silly answers are also welcome, right? There is no black and white, there is no right and wrong, right? Even if you give a right answer, wrong answer, I will at the end tell you, okay, what's the best answer? Right, that is why I'm here. So don't be afraid, show up. Right? This might be one of that steps you need to build your confidence muscle. Right? So Shruti and Ibrahim are absolutely right. Grishma says that growth in revenue and scale, definitely, because if you can close more high ticket sales, you can expand much more easily. Now I'm at that level where I'm about to start, I have done organic things. Now what I'm doing is I'm about to start a model in which I'm going to do organic things as well as paid things. So I'm going to combine the superpowers of organic marketing as well as inorganic marketing for my high ticket sales business. Right? Because there are times when organic also slows down, but there are times when inorganic also slows down. But when you combine both of these methods, that's where the best of both worlds is. Okay, awesome. So what happens when you go in an okay, Praveen, what does he say? Let me read it out. One second, what does he say? Praveen has also written something. So Praveen, what does he write? Okay, so Praveen writes, to work with premium clients, and premium clients don't bother much. That is a very good answer, actually. When I started working with premium clients, can I tell you, they were super committed. Not just committed, super committed. If I said the class is at 3 p.m., that means 3 p.m. sharp. Even some of them would just log in 5 minutes early because that was their level of dedication, right? So you're absolutely right. Right? So why should you learn high ticket? If you see, if you get into high ticket, the number one thing is you get more money into your business. When can you charge high ticket? When you help somebody solve a big problem, right? When you help them solve a big problem, you get a bigger paycheck. For example, if I get a small cut in my thumb, will I rush to the doctor? No, I will not. I will just put a bandage and be fine. But if I get a serious injury in my thumb, now will I rush? If my thumb is not moving, will I rush? Absolutely. I will do whatever it takes to go to the doctor and get it fixed, no matter how much the doctor is charging, right? Because it's a bigger problem. It's not a small cut. In the similar way, in your coaching, in your consulting, whatever business you are doing, when you help others win big, you make more money. They also make more money because they are solving bigger problems because of you. Like, for example, in your case, Shruti, like I have another relationship coach in my community. So she had a client, right? And this is a very interesting story. So she had a client who was pregnant, right? She came back to her parents because, there were a lot of fights between the husband and wife. And the marriage was on the verge of breaking up. Now she's pregnant with a baby, she's carrying a baby, and she has come back to her parents' house. She's all desolate, lonely, depressed. She doesn't know. She contacted, this relationship coach. And, after a couple of 3 months or so, that guy who was fighting and these two people who had so many misunderstandings, they came back. Right? Now, can you put a price tag to that? You can't. This is priceless. So, will the person pay more? Well, yes, because his life is at stake, right? So now that I think that she charged 1.5 lakh from that client, because imagine if she went through separation and all of that, how much trauma, how much money, how much lawyers, how much all of these people would have taken. But then when she got the right relationship coach, everything sorted, right? So that is the power. That is the power of, getting clients who have such big problems. And when you solve big problems, you get money, more money out of them, right? So these people, okay, so you win big by helping others win big. It's a win-win situation. Always remember, it's a win-win situation. The second thing what happens is you attract more committed clients. As I was already telling, when I signed up premium clients, they were not one of those that I will think and I will say and I will do this and that. No, they were people who were serious. They took the action, they paid, and they took what was required and they took their business to the next level. Right? Because when you pay more, You understand more. When you understand more, you actually get more results. Right? Yeah, better results. Okay. So that is one of the things that happens. And then, okay, I'll ask you a simple question. If there is a Rolex, okay, and there is a brand title, between these two, which one has more credibility? If there are two watches kept, and if you had everything which was required to buy that, you have all the money, all the resources, all the time, people would go for a Rolex, why? Because that, yeah, everybody would go for a Rolex. Why people are going for a Rolex? Because when you charge more and you give good results, people want to continue buying from you only because you are somebody who guarantees them better results. All right. Maybe they go to a cheaper person or a cheaper brand that does not give them the kind of experience that that brand gives. Right? So that is why you have more credibility also. Why more credibility? Because you are getting better clients, you're getting better things, you are serving more, and that is why you are having better credibility. And people are okay paying more. All right? And finally, you get more freedom. Can I tell you, I was not working with more than four clients in a month when I started doing high ticket sales, because each client required a good amount of time. And but I did not have to deal with 40 or 400 clients, just four clients in a month, and I'm done. Right? So when you are just dealing with four clients, there's less stress on your head, right? You know, only these many people, right? And when you have less people, you have more time, you have more freedom, you have more money, you have the luxury to do whatever you want in your life. So there's more flexibility because of that, right? Premium prices goes for brands, yes, definitely. When you become a brand, you can also charge premium, and for that you have to also become a brand. Okay, so now why should we learn about the psychology? Why am I focusing, or why is this entire session on psychology, and not why I'm not giving that just one sales script? Because I can easily explain a sales script also. You know why? Because, as I was earlier saying, that no pain equals to no sale. And to understand when a sales can happen, see, the गंजे को कंघी बेचना कोई सेल करना नहीं होता. इफ यू आर सेलिंग अ कॉम टू अ बॉल्ड पर्सन, दैट्स नॉट सेल्स. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड डज दैट पर्सन नीड इट और नॉट. And how do you know it? When you understand him, when you understand the other person, when you understand the psychology. There are people, right, who come to me and I deny that I can't coach you because you know what? They have that syndrome. I know it all. Have you met those people? They're stuck in their life. They will come all sorts of problems. But when you start giving solution, they're like, ye toh mujhe pata tha. I know this. I know it all. Have you experienced that? Right? So therefore, you also have to qualify people. And how can you qualify people? When you understand what is going on in their minds. Are they ready? Are they not ready? Do they require a month? Do they require? There are clients, they met me like 6 months back, and now they've started working with me because maybe at this point of time they felt ready. And back then I didn't also push. I realized, because if they had come half-heartedly, my job as a coach would become much more tough. So I let them be, right? I let them be. Therefore, as a coach, it is very, very important to understand what is the emotion of that buyer, what is that thought process, what is their decision making like, right? And only then you can understand if there would be a sale or there would be no sale. Also, what happens is, when a person comes, and you understand what is their needs, what are their desires, you can position your offer in the right manner. Like, there are clients, I know they can't afford my premium services. That is not for them. maybe I have to offer something which is mid-ticket, right? And maybe they will only get then my group coaching. They will not get my premium one-on-one services because they are also not ready, right? That is not the kind of money that they have or the time they have, right? So understanding helps you position and personalize that offer. Maybe, see, every client is different. You need to understand where that client will fall and then be selective, right? Be selective about the people that you work, right? And finally, right, it is not always about logic. Can we all agree that we are all emotional beings? We don't make decisions based on logic, rather on the emotions. Monkey see, monkey do, right? A friend buys a new iPhone and we want to buy the same iPhone. You know why? Not because we have a need, but because that friend bought. A friend buys a car and suddenly we feel like, buying that car. A friend goes on a holiday to Mauritius and now we want to go to Mauritius only, although there are other countries that we can go to, but no, where we have to go? Mauritius. Why? Monkey see, monkey do, right? We connect, we feel connected. The moment we feel connected, emotionally connected, there is a bond, there is an emotional charge, the sale happens very, very easily. I'll tell you a recent example. I went to a skincare store, right? I was looking for something because my skin is kind of very sensitive also. So I was looking for something which was suited to my skin. I was not sure what type of skin I have. Like my skin, sometimes it gets a little oily, sometimes it gets a very dry. So what happened is, as I walked inside that store, there was a very beautiful lady, right? And she walked up to me and she gave me one of the best sales experiences of my life. Instead of randomly just suggesting a product, you know what she did? She said, "Ma'am, you know what? I want to suggest the best product for you," right? She established a rapport. She made me sit down. She clicked a picture of my skin. She did a skin test. And she told me what is my skin type, right? And then she suggested some proper lotions according to my skin. And then she suggested, "Okay, ma'am, don't go for these products, go for this one. And you just don't need a skin product, you need something to drink also, because we need internal hydration, we need internal cleaning also." So she gave me one cream and one those sachets that helps you cleanse your body, detox your body. Now, can you tell me, did I buy from her or not? Obviously. You know why? Why do you think I bought from her? I needed just one cream and she sold me like five products. Why do you think that happened? People are writing, "She understood you. She understood your problem." Exactly, Meena. She understood me. She actually became my good advisor. Yeah, she gave the right solution. And she, instead of being a pushy salesperson, like you must have seen those salespeople at the mall, they're like, "No, take this, take that." She was not being that. She understood what I needed. She first diagnosed my need and then suggested what's the best for me. So, what was in my mind? She's my good friend. She's like my good advisor. She's my guide. That's the feeling. And as a coach, once you start building that rapport, it's very easy. The people will not see that as a transaction. People will see that this is a person who is your advocate for your growth. He's a champion for your transformation. They will not see you as just somebody who's just selling another product, another service, another package. Right? And that is why the psychology part comes. Right? Yeah. So psychology is very, very important because mindset goes unset. Our mindset is very, very keen to get unset. And therefore, we have to work on our psychology. We have to also understand the psychology of the customer so that we are always winning. All right? Awesome. So now I'm going to share the seven secrets, the seven things in high ticket sales which are crucial, absolutely crucial. If you want to be high ticket closer, you need to know these seven psychological principles. All right? So number one is fears. Number one thing that we have is, if we want to be a top-notch closer, is we need to overcome our fear. Can we all agree we all have fear of failure? Fear of success also. Fear of money also. Now, if you want to be a high-ticket closer, can you afford all these fears? Fear of failure, fear of success. A lot of people are like, what if the client says no? What if the client says no? That is their biggest fear. Have you all experienced that? They're so scared that they're not going on that sales call. They're not talking to that client. They're not going to that lead. They're not doing that follow-up because they're dead scared. Because since childhood, every time they made a request to their parents, to their teacher or somebody, they heard no so many times that their self-worth started affecting because of that. But how do we overcome these fears? Be it fear of success. A lot of times people feel that if I become too successful, I will not be able to give time to my family. My health will degrade. A lot of people have these notions. Have you also had such experiences where your family member or somebody says, okay, people who work a lot, you know what happens? They become very fat because they're sitting all day on the chair, or they're not socially connected, or they forget their families. They don't become nice people. Have you heard all of that? Is it true? I'll tell you an example. I have a friend, right? She runs a school, right? She runs a beautiful school. She's a beautiful mother, a beautiful wife, and one of the sweetest friend in my life. And fortunately, she lives right across my house. So every day I'm coming from the gym or I'm coming from somewhere, I would just say, hi, hi Limna, how are you doing? Right? I've never seen, you know, I've never understood this concept of, you know, hating success and thinking that if I become successful, I'll not be healthy or happy or not be able to sustain relationships. This is all in our minds. And so why a lot of people are not able to close a lot of sales? Because they think if I make a lot of money, society will not accept me. My parents will not accept me. Even one person said that if I become very successful and rich, somebody might kidnap my family members, my kids. People have that level of fears. You know, गुंडे उठा के ले जाएंगे अगर बहुत रिच बन गए तो. These are the kind of fears people have, right? And what is it doing? Whatever the mind can't accept, it will automatically reject. So the moment you will get on that sales call, you'll say, oh, the sales is coming, but I don't feel ready. If a lot of money comes, then what will happen? Also, there is a fear of money. People think money is the root of all evil. Have you heard? Come on, guys, tell me, have you heard in your school, in your childhood, money is hard to earn. Money is this, money. Are money is nothing. Money is neutral. You can kill people, you can give life to people. Right? There are literally countries, big countries, bombing other smaller nations because they want to capture those nations. And there are billionaires who are feeding people in Africa. Melinda Gates Foundation is the biggest example. They have donated billions of dollars just to take care of these poor, unfortunate people. So, is money good or bad? Money is nothing. So, what do we need? How do we overcome our fears? Can anyone tell me, if I want to overcome my fear, what is that one step I need to take? What's the first step I need to take? If I need to overcome my fears, what is it I need to do? Change mindset, yes, but how do we change mindset? Because mindset is very, very deep rooted. Somebody has so many beliefs which are from his childhood. How do we change that belief? So the first thing is, what is a belief? Let me just break it down. It is a belief, right? Whatever we believe, we act, and then we get the result. Can we all agree? Belief, whatever we believe, according to that, we have our skills, whatever skills we develop, and that develops our character. So fundamentally, whatever we want to change, we need to change that belief. So how do we change that belief? So a belief is like a table. Have you seen a table? This is a table, and let's imagine these are the four legs. Like these are the imaginary legs. So the moment you start breaking the legs, the moment somebody says money is bad, why do you think? Melinda Gates Foundation, they did, they're billionaires, they did so much good for the society. How can you think so? Money is neutral. It's what you do with it. So the moment you start breaking the legs of this table, do you see the table is smashed? It's gone. Can you call a table which has no legs a table? It's gone. Similarly, that belief, you need to break its legs, right? Because you can have, I can teach you all the sales skills, all the things, but what will happen when you go on that sales call? I recently consulted a client. He had great leads. His ads were running, his organic business was running. But what was happening? The moment he got on that sales part and he got on to pitch his offer, he would be like, okay, now it is up to you. Do you want to buy? And if the person gave even one objection, he would not handle that objection. He would be like, okay. Why was that happening? Because he had not overcome his fear of rejection, his fear of success, his fear of money. He still thought that money is bad. And that is why he was not able to overcome that fear. Is it relatable, by the way, guys? Am I making sense? Ibrahim, Shruti, Meena, Grishma, right? Is it making sense to all of you? Does this happen? And the moment you change that belief, you can start gathering the right skills. Because the moment I say money is good, I start attracting things which help me make more money. And then my character becomes of a person who is a money maker. Right? So belief, when you change the belief, it's the easiest step that changes your skills and that changes your character. All right? And one simple thing that you can do is face your fears more often. If you're scared of, for example, if somebody is scared of swimming, what will the person do? The person needs to get more into the pool. So if you're scared of sales calls, go and do more sales calls. If you are scared of talking to strangers, go and talk to more strangers. Yeah, get a swimming coach. Yeah, that's the best because there are two ways to learn something. Learn through the trials and tribulations and all the hard ways, or get a coach. You will fast track your life. Right? So this me and see, why I'll tell you all of this. Our mind is like a garden, right? Mind is like a garden. If there are a lot of weeds, can you place nice flowers? The weeds will even overpower the flowers. So first you need to remove these limiting beliefs, these fears, because once you remove these fears, then comes the next step, which is your confidence, right? So a lot of people think that fear, this failure is final, but failure isn't final, success isn't permanent. You need to keep going. I'll give you one of the finest examples. Shah Rukh Khan, has he given hits? Yes. Has he also given flops? Yes. Has he stopped because of his flops? Never. Is he relevant still? Are people still buying his movies? Is he still selling his movies? Yes. Why? Because he has overcome these fears. He has overcome the fear of failure, the fear of success. Somebody asked Shah Rukh, right? Somebody asked Shah Rukh, Shah Rukh, don't you want to have go out and have Pani Puri? He said, no, I have worked very, very, very hard to be where I am. You can cut my one arm and another. And just take away whatever you want, but not my fame, but not the position that I've built in life. I have worked really, really hard to become who I am, to be recognizable. I don't want to cover up myself. I don't want to, if I want to have pani puri, the pani puri will come inside. If I want to have some bhel puri, something, it will come inside. I don't need to go outside. So see the mindset and how successful he is, because he has overcome his fears. Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan was one of the finest basketball players in this world. And you know what? He was not selected in his college basketball team. Shocking, right? World's best basketball player not selected in his college basketball team. Did that stop him? No. He said that I will take it like a challenge and I will still win. So, you know, this mindset keeps you in the long term. It keeps you relevant in the long term. You might learn a sales script and then forget the concepts and then go to ground zero. Why? Because the mindset became unset, right? So therefore, now we have taken out the weeds from the garden of your mind. Now we need to plant good flowers. And what is the most important flower? That is the flower of confidence. That is the flower of confidence. Confidence is very, very, very crucial. Your confidence, I had one of my mentors and he said to me once, Taiba, there are people who are half as talented as you and making 10 times the money as much, you know, 10 times more money than you. I asked why or how. He said, because they are confident on themselves. And they know how to sell. They are confident on themselves. Have you seen some people in the ad and you feel like, oh my God, I feel I can do better than this person. I know more than this person. Why is this person making more? Because that person is confident. He's taking the actions and therefore getting those results. So how do we become confident? Can we all have some answers? How do we become confident in sales especially? If you want to become a high ticket closer, how do you absolutely become confident within yourself? We keep trying, but what do we keep trying? What do we keep trying? Come on, guys, keep writing some answers. That will just stir up your brain. By doing more sales call, very good. But how do we, more failures, that is good. But how do we build that muscle of confidence? In especially when you're building a high-ticket product or whatever it is based on three things. Three things you need in order to be confident with your high-ticket product, which is first your product itself. It is said that you are your own biggest or the hardest customer. You know why? Because if you can't convince yourself that your product is worth it, you can't convince somebody else. So you need to be, yes, you need to know the product and you need to keep iterating. Maybe, see, when I started 2 years back with all these things, I was testing a lot of things with a small batches of people. I was testing all of this with very, very premium clients. And they told me, okay, you need to add this, you need to add that, you need to add this. And then finally, I came up with my final product. Right? So you need to keep iterating, because what happens when you're iterating? You know, at this time, I have the best product. I've done the best. I've done the research. My customer has told me whatever the feedback he has given, I've done the best. Right? So how do we make the best product? You know your customer. Number one, know your customer. Talk to your customer. Talk to your customer. Talk to your customer. Right? And whatever he says, just listen. The second thing is you also need to understand your own self. You need to understand your inner world. Yes, you need to believe in yourself. Yes, you need to believe in yourself. That is also very, very important. Now, when I say you need to understand your own inner world, what does that mean? What does your inner world mean? When I say you need to understand your inner world, what does that mean? What do you think that means? You need to understand your triggers. You need to understand your values. You need to understand your strengths. And you also need to understand your weaknesses. You know why? When you go on that sales call, The client will grill you from all the angles, not just from one angle. The client will grill you from all the different angles. If you are aware of your strengths, your weaknesses, you know which ball is coming your way. Like, for example, I had a client, right? And she was like, you know, I want to do this in 4 months. But I said, no, I need 6 months to, you know, help you go to that level. And she said, no, Taiba, I know I can do it in 4 months. And that time, I kind of knew my weakness. I take the time a little extra because sometimes there are some lags, there are some challenges, and therefore you need that gap, right? And later she said, I'm confident with you. I really want to go ahead with you. Because I knew my weakness, that I always overestimate a little bit, and I do that on purpose because I want that if there is any lag, there is no disappointment in front of the client. They feel okay. That was what was expected. Right? So, therefore, you need to understand your weaknesses. Because if you don't understand your weaknesses, and the moment you go on a client call and that client asks you that question, which hits your weakness, you are like blank. You are in shock. You don't know what to say. But when you are aware of your weaknesses, you can acknowledge it in a better manner because you know which ball it is coming and you know you have an idea how to deal with that. So you need to know your strength. You also need to know your weaknesses. You need to know your values. Sometimes there would be client who would, you know, expect things that you don't offer in your program. Right? I had a client who and I, we did have a program, but then what happened was she wanted my most premium level with that same program. I clarified, I tried to explain her, but she was not understanding. After a while, I actually said, see, if you want to get into that program, these are the things that you have to do. And then finally, she understood, okay, what does it require? First, you also need to be ready mentally because it's not just money, it's also the mindset. Because you can maybe pay the money, manage, take some credit. But if you're not ready, if you're not coachable, it's not easy. I gave her some assignment, and after a few weeks, I couldn't hear from her. And that's when she also realized maybe I'm just not ready right now. Right? So you need to understand your own values, where you have to align, which client you have to let go of. There are times that I let go of my clients because they're not coachable. Right? So knowing your values is very, very important. And number three, can you tell me the third thing which is most important in order to be super confident within yourself, within your product, within your services? The third most important thing, anyone? What's the third most important thing you need to do in order to feel confident within your product, within your service, whatever you're providing? Any guesses? No right or wrong answers. You can just guess. It is knowing your competitors. Because if you don't know your competitors, their pricing, their strategies, the market trends, what will happen is the client will come and say, hey, that person is providing this service for just 15,000 and you are taking 1.5 lakh. And then you have to say, you know what, in 15,000, he'll just give you a random recorded course. But on the other hand, here, we actually work with you one-on-one. We give you hand holding. We give you a teammate who will support you. We have accountability calls. There would be a specific team member who will ask you about your work. And we have a money back guarantee. Right? Anytime within 15 days or 2 weeks, you don't feel satisfied, 100% money back. No questions asked. Right? So if you understand what's going on in the market, only then you can be confident. Otherwise, the client would start comparing you only on the price because that's all he knows. But then you have to know the deeper level stuff, the kind of transformation that you are providing. And you have to never badmouth your competition. I never say that person is bad or that person is good. Right? I say, see, they have a different method of doing things. This is how I do things. If you want to go their way, that is your choice, but this is what we are offering. Right? Because when you badmouth other person, it just brings a lot of negativity, and that's just not good on your part. You should be honest and you should tell the truth, because there are times where when I say that, you know, if you know so much, why, how can I help you? There are clients, they don't even know what the problem they're facing. They will say, you know, I've tried this, I've tried that, I've tried that. Then I say, okay, what do you need then? How can I help you? And then they say, oh, you know what? That was the point. I don't know how to align my content, or I don't know how to launch my offers, or maybe there's a problem with my offerings. Right? So you have to be like, you have to really dig down what's going on in their mind and understand them to tell that what is this. So confidence is one of your most important assets, because if you're underconfident, what will happen is it will start reflecting in your voice, in your body language, in the way you speak, everything. Right? And when you are underconfident, that energy will transcend into your client in a moment, and they will knock out. Right? So that is why it is very, very important that you build up strong confidence. And these things that I've given, these will provide a very, very solid foundation for you to build your confidence muscle. All right. Third thing is futures over features. What is that? Futures over features. Can anybody explain me what is futures over features? What is futures over features? What is futures over features? Any idea, anyone? What is futures over features? Making prospect envision the future when they buy. Yeah, pretty bang on. Telling the client they will reach by. Yes. A lot of times I've seen a lot of coaches, they will say, okay, I have these 8 modules. The first module I'll teach this, second. That's all fine. But you know, when you go into that Apple store, that person is not busy explaining you the features. That person tells you the outcome. How clear the picture would be, how it would make you feel, right? You don't need to have a DSLR. One Apple phone and you're done. A lot of creative people, they buy Apple products. Why? Because Apple is not selling just some products. They're not selling electronic products. They are selling creativity. Nike is not selling shoes. It's selling innovation, right? Zara is not selling clothes. Zara is selling fast fashion. How you can, you know, just get new trends every single month, right? So we have to learn. One of my coaches used to say that type of always, always, always tell the outcome of the outcome of the outcome of the outcome. Now you would be saying, what am I saying? See, for example, if you come into high ticket sales, what will happen? You will be able to make more money. What happens when you make more money? You can upgrade your lifestyle. When you upgrade your lifestyle, you can go on those vacations you have been wanting. You can have more time. You can have more quality relationships. You can have more money for investing in your health. You can take those. You can take a personal trainer if you already don't have one. So what did this happen? Outcome ke outcome ka outcome ka outcome, right? What was the outcome? So in the similar way, if somebody is selling some yoga training, they don't have to tell, okay, how will what are the asanas we are doing, or what are the classes. You have to tell, okay, in 6 weeks you'd be able to lose 2 kgs, 3 kgs, 5 kgs. Your skin will become brighter. Your hair will become more shiny. You will feel more energetic. You can go for a run in the middle of the day. You'll have that kind of energy. Now, does that excite you? Yes, that does excite you. All right. So therefore, will the person buy? Because he's not buying features. People don't buy features, they buy futures. Therefore, whenever you are pitching a product, you are selling a high-ticket product especially, always project their future, not features. Are we good? Are we good, everyone? Are we all active and alive? I can only see Shruti. everybody else is just off the camera, so I can't really gauge what's going on. Okay, awesome. The fourth very important thing that a great closer does is handling objections. See, a small time closer talks a lot. He tries to convince a lot. You know why? Because he sees objections as roadblocks. But on the other hand, the big time closer, he asks great questions. If somebody says, "I feel this product is expensive," instead of saying, no, that, this, that," he will not give an explanation. He will say, "What makes you think so?" And then he will tell, "You know that competitor is selling that product for that much." And then this person will say, "Oh, is it? And do you think, is it of the same quality?" And then he says, "No, I don't think, because higher the price, higher the value." So did you see what this high-ticket person does? He is great at asking questions, relevant, specific questions. He's not trying to convince a lot. He's just trying to create a need through the client. Because sometimes a client does not know what he does not know. Right? Sometimes when a person says, "Oh, it is too expensive," so instead of saying, giving another argument, no, this is not expensive, convincing, trying to push, you can simply say, "I thought it was a big problem. If it is not that a big problem, then it's okay." And then that person will suddenly get shocked. "What is this person saying? No, it's a big problem. And I think it," so don't you think it requires that kind of budget also, that kind of allocation also? All right. So what a big time closer is doing, you know what? He is showing a lot of empathy also. "I understand your situation. I know what it feels like." But at the same time, he is creating the need always. And he is taking the need from the client. Because if the client, what do you do when the client says, "I can't afford you?" You can simply say that, okay, if a client says, "I can't afford you," then you can simply say, then you can say, "It's not that important to you. That means this problem is not so important. I'm sorry, I thought you could this thing matter to you." And if it matters, imagine you can give this scenario also. For example, God forbid, if any of us sitting here, if we had a loved one and suddenly something happened to that loved one, that person is hospitalized, and the doctor says, "We need to operate this person right now, but first you need to pay 5 lakh rupees. Will you think twice about that money? Because it's urgent, it's important. In the similar way, if something is important, if something is so important to you, it is a dream, it is a relationship, it is your health, whatever it is hospitalized, it is in crisis. Now, would you pay that attention?" So, Meena, were you able to get the answer? Okay, so that is how, see, it is all about understanding. What makes you say so? You can even say, "Okay, I can't afford," but if you had to afford it somehow, how can we make it possible for you? Because sales is also about opening up avenues which the client also did not think he had. I had a client, and we sold a product of 1.5 lakh. So she said, "Tiber, you know what? I really want to do this program, but right now I just have 50,000. So I said, "What can I do for you to make this affordable, to make this thing, easy for you?" And she said, "I want 3 payments. I want to pay 50,000 every single month, and that way in 3 installments I would be able to do this." So, Meena, you can even ask that, "How can I make this easy, like this price? What can I do?" If it is a high-ticket product that you're selling, if it is a low-ticket product, see, everybody can manage. People can manage. They just have a lot of excuses. Everybody has a money for things they want to do. Right? People literally have seen so many people, like in when it comes to women, a lot of women buy these luxury bags, and they sometimes cost in lakhs. So if somebody can buy that luxury bag, they can also buy a coaching program that can be much more useful than that bag, right? It is all about priorities. All right. Okay, with that, we will go to our so see, objections is always buying signals. A high ticket closer never sees these objections like a roadblock. He always asks, what makes you think so? He asks good questions. He always creates the need so that the client himself says, oh, I need this. You know what? I really need this. Right? So what happens? A high ticket closer, he acts like a doctor. He first analyzes, diagnoses the whole problem, and then says, you know what? I feel this could work for you. Right? Do you think it can work? And then that person says, ah, I feel, you know, I'm lagging at this, I'm lagging at this. I think I need it. Right? So that person first creates the need and then asks the customer, do you think if I solve all of these problems, this would be a good fit for you? And if that person is committed, he will solve the problem, she will solve the problem. However, there are clients who are very, very stubborn, like I've been on sales calls where person knows he needs it, but he is lacking the mindset. He still needs more push, maybe more, he needs more inner work, right? So that's fine, but you need to do your best part as a you know, as a person who is in who's selling a product, right? So fifth thing is anchoring and positioning, very, very important. Okay, I'll give a very simple example for this. For example, if I say I have two programs. One is my high ticket program, which I charge 1.5 lakh. And for that program, I provide everything. The whole organic marketing, ads, how do you set up your ads, organic marketing, all of that. And how do you start selling high ticket? All of that I teach you. But in my premium program, you will get my group coaching as well as my personalized coaching. So you meet me once for personalized coaching and once for a group coaching. You get one teammate who's dedicated to you, who's doing the work, right? Who's checking your sheets, who's checking your assignments. Everything is tracked in Google Sheets. And then I have the same program. Content-wise, it is same, but it is only a group program. My team members are not assigned to you. I don't have so much personal involvement with you. I don't take one-on-one classes, but the content remains same. Now, how does this 15,000 program look like? Very affordable. Because content-wise, everything is just the same. So that is how if you, and if I had to sell this 1.5 lakh offer, if that was what I was selling, then I would sell even more higher offer, which was premium. I would say, okay, I have a even more premium program, which is at 3 lakh, where we do everything for you. Okay, we create your landing pages, we create your ads, we approve your ad scripts, we do everything. You just have to come, you have to just do the work which is required, and you don't have to think about where to create ads, what. Then 1.5 lakh, now it seems like a steal the deal kind of thing. Why? Because that was the anchor. So what is an anchor? Anchor is like, you know how we tie a boat from an anchor? So in the similar manner, this is the place which is holding the other thing. Okay, so the higher priced offer is holding the next. So if you, so whatever you want to sell, if imagine if I started selling a 15,000 rupees program with starting with 1,000 rupees. I have a program of 1,000, then 2,000, then people will say, oh my God, 15,000 is very much. Right, but when I'm starting with 1.5 lakh and then taking it down to what, just 15,000 for a group coaching, seems like a fantastic deal, right? Because you'd be learning high ticket sales, everything, the content wise, everything is the same, but it's just a group program. My personal involvement or my team's personal involvement is not there. All right, good with this? Anchoring and positioning. Another example, for example, if you saw a watch, a 50,000 rupee watch. right? And a salesman, but you say, oh my God, I really don't have the budget. I wish I could buy this. This is the best watch I've seen in a long time. But then the salesman comes and he shows you a similar watch with similar features, with similar look and feel, but it is 10,000. Now, does that 10,000 feel a lot? You feel like I want to grab it because the higher book was 50,000. All right. So that is what anchoring and positioning is all about. You don't have to lower your prices. You just have to present it the right way. A lot of times when I ask people, do you need to lower the prices and can lowering the prices help you with your sales? No, it can't because you have not anchored and positioned your products in the right manner. So you need to anchor it and position it in the right way, right? And the sixth thing is emotional connection. There is a magic when you connect with people one on one, right? There's a line which I can never forget, which is people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. Right? People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. If you care for people and they really feel that you are the his or her trusted advisor, they will come back to you just like that salesperson I was talking about. I bought five products. I just went to buy just one cream and I ended up buying four, five things. Why? Because I really felt connected to that lady. The kind of product she was showing me, the way she was talking to me, she was saying, you are not hydrating yourself. You are not taking care of this. You don't have a morning skin routine. You don't have an evening skin routine. Now, she was talking not like a salesperson. She was talking like a sister. And can I tell you, we have to act like a trusted advisor, like a friend. Because if we don't act in the goodwill of other people, they might chuck out. They might not feel connected with us. So, all the tactics, everything aside, but emotional mastery aside, because we are emotional human beings. Human beings are emotions. We don't take decisions based on logic. We take decisions based on the magic of emotions. Right? And emotions, when you genuinely help somebody out, there are calls where I have helped somebody so much that other person referred me to somebody. He said, you know what, Taiba, you've helped me so much. My doubt is solved, but I have a friend who really needs your services. Please, can you help that person? And that person became my client. I did not get a direct sale, but I got an indirect sale. That is what happens when you are jet. When you wanna go on a sales call, whatever call, just be there to serve that person. Just be there. Just open yourself, open your heart, mind to just answer whatever questions they have. All right. And final, very, very important thing, you can share some relatable stories. You can share the story of a client. Like I shared the client story of my client Khushbu, who's also a relationship coach. Right? She's doing really well. Right? So she's saving so many relationships. Now, I can confidently say that I've helped various people from various fields, so I can help you guys as well. All right, so genuine care is very, very important. And final is you need to have a mindset of abundance. There is no dearth, like there's no scarcity of people. You need just a few thousand people to sell and, have a successful business. There are 8 billion people on this planet. You don't need to be desperate. A lot of people, they just lower the prices because they feel, oh, how will I get another client? God damn, there are 8 billion people. Reach out to new people. Remove those people who are bargaining, who are haggling with you like a vegetable vendor. Right? You don't have to act like a vegetable vendor. You are transforming people's life and they don't have a right to haggle with you like that. But who sets those standards? You have to be selective. If a client is not coachable, you don't have to, push very hard. In fact, you have to, push him away. It's okay to not take clients. There are so many people who are in need of your products and services. You just have to reach out to them. Whether you do inbound marketing, which is through organic, or you go through ads, whatever you do, you just can reach people. All right. So these were the seven fundamentals. Now we have a Q&A. Does anyone have any questions related to anything that we have discussed? Anything? Do you have any questions? Please feel free to ask any questions, and then we will actually, I'll give you the link of my. Anyone has any questions related to anything, high ticket sales or anything? Because today we just talked about the psychology part. Okay.
Yeah, it was quite clear. Yeah, I understood everything. So yeah, no questions from my side.
Okay, awesome. So if there are no questions, what I would do is I would here is your gift. One second. So I'm going to give the gift. So are you guys excited for your gift? Gift? Okay, so I'm going to give away your gift. But before that, I really want to thank each one of you for just being here, being interactive, being here. And I just want to say, see, this is a call where we had nine people. If one had a deep issue with their business or high ticket sales, I can't go very deep. If you want to connect with me one-on-one, I have a few slots. Most of my slots are gone and I have a few slots. So what I'll do is I'll first share the link of my Calendly. Please grab the link so that I can help you more if you are stuck somewhere with your high ticket sales. And if you want me to just, you know, understand your challenges, what are those exact challenges? Because here I can't really dig deep. I can't really understand what's going on with your business. I need to understand your funnel. I need to understand what's going on in your business to help you. One second. So I'll just give my link to the Calendly call. Oh, my computer is a little stuck. In that meantime, if anyone has any questions, please feel free to ask your questions. I will be happy to answer those questions. By the way, guys, how was your session? Tell me, how was the session? You can unmute yourself right now and you can say, okay, Shruti says awesome. What was the highlight for you? What was one like bulb on moment? You can unmute yourself and say.
That self-doubt thing that got stuck because I was in that zone for a long time. And finally, by doing it more and more, putting myself out there on social media, I think that is gone now. I am out of that phase, but I was stuck there for a while. So yeah, I understand that. I could just relate to so much to that.
Awesome. That's great. That's
Yeah.
great. Okay. So Grishma says it was the mindset and beliefs. Yes, your beliefs are building your life. I always say your beliefs are building your life. And your mindset, it's very easy to get it unset. Right? Mindset gets unset very, very often. Therefore, mindset is required every day, every day, every day. Before every session, we have this mindset talk because we want to be a long-term player. We don't want to be a sprinter. We want to be a marathon runner, right? And that can only happen when we have the right mindset. So I have shared the link of my Calendly call. If anybody is interested to get on a call where I understand your business deeply, or if you want to know any of my offerings, right? In case after doing the call, you feel that you can connect with me and I have something exciting because we have some early bird offers, right? Some crazy offers which are coming up. I'm doing it for just very few people. So it's a limited slot. We are already having very few slots. So if you feel you are the one, please go ahead, click on the link, book your calls. Just save the link right now because it has few questions also that you need to answer in order for me to book the call. And if you are qualified, then we will give you a call. Okay. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll connect with you personally, and then after 2 days I'll try to open a new slot and then we can connect. Okay, so now is that golden moment where I shared this document, which is my high converting sales script. So what you can do is just click on the link and make a copy of this, right? And you can save it in your Google Drive. This Script has really helped me because when you understand the mindset and when you apply it in the correct manner, magic happens. Now, obviously, I can't share that entire thing. It's not possible. I have multiple classes where I help people undergo this journey. We understand the mindset, we train them on skill set, and we do a lot of role play where I act as your client. And that's a tough role play, and that is where the magic happens. You learn so much, you can start giving answers that you never thought you had. Because with practice, your sales muscle starts growing. So we do these three things. Number one, mindset, number two, skill set, and number three, we also make you do a lot of role plays. And after doing all these role plays, you feel like a champion and you start closing sales left, right, and center. Right? So can you all come on the camera? I'll just take a nice picture of everyone and then we'll call it a day. Can we all come on the camera? So let's do a victory sign. Okay, awesome everyone. It was lovely meeting you all. Please take care of yourself. Copy the sales script. Get in touch with me if you want to, get on with your sales training with me. I'll help you. And yeah, so Shruti, what you can do is you can drop your number here, or
Okay.
do we? Yeah, you can drop your number in the chat, and one of my team members will get in touch with you. And
Sure.
okay, awesome. So I have your number. Take care of yourself, guys. We'll
Thank you
meet.
so much, Taiba.
Do you want to say anything about the session or how was your experience today?
Actually, I quite resonated with a lot of stuff you shared, and few things I actually learned that how to, if you understand your client better, the it's easier to make a sale there, because the empathy I think plays a major role. So yeah, so that was the learning, and I haven't tried high ticket yet, but I really want to now, because low ticket sales are actually quite draining in my niche especially, and I really want to put that effort and earn more too. So yeah, I'm planning to do a high ticket now. So this will help surely.
Okay, awesome. So we'll connect with you one on one. One of the
Sure.
team members will get in touch with you and we'll get a call set up to help
Perfect.
you get started.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome, Shruti. Thank you so much. Take
Thank
care.
you. Bye-bye.